Hello everyone, and thank you for joining us for today's webinar. My name is Zaid Al-Omari. I'm the Senior Solution Engineer at BeyondTrust. To whom who don't know about BeyondTrust, BeyondTrust is a leading provider of privileged access management. Today's agenda is to present our new universal privilege management platform. So please, if you have any questions during the presentation, keep them with you so we can answer all of these questions during our time in the virtual booth. I will go now ahead and take you through the whole platform of our business. I will discuss the high level architecture of our components, and then we will close the session with a live demo. Let's start discussing the attack surface that we are facing today. The attack surface for any environment is a sum of different points where the unauthorized user, or sometimes we call it the attacker, try to enter data or extract a data from an environment. So some customer, they are owning the traditional IT environment, but the other, they are growing and expanding to cloud environment. They are moving to IoT or development operation, because they need to expand their business and they need to increase the profit of the company. Whatever the environment types at the end, these environments will include many technologies. So we are concerning about routers, we are having firewalls, we have databases, servers, applications, you know, and other technologies and systems. We have three main security issues and problems from this transformations and moving the customer to new environments. So companies start seeing more unknown and unmanaged privilege credentials and secrets. This is really hard to be managed when the number of users who need privilege is growing rapidly. And these privilege accounts may not only traditional administrators, as we know, but we are talking about external vendor who need a privilege access. We are talking about a help desk and non-human accounts, like for example, application or service accounts. Second thing, we have increase in security gaps in terms of accountability, auditing. We have a leakage of compliance and reporting. And the last thing, we are losing really the visibility on these privilege accounts activity. But there, what they are doing, what these privilege accounts, you know, try to perform in our critical systems and environment. So as a leader in privilege access management, we are trying to keep the attack surface as small as possible. You know, we are looking to decrease this from privilege perspective. We are looking to privilege accounts so we can secure this environment. PAM solution access the market to solve these problems that we are mentioned early in the previous slide, which all of them related to privilege accounts. The slide shows BeyondTrust PAM platform, which mainly centers on three major pillars. We have a privilege password and session management, and this is, you know, the first block in our slide. We have endpoint privilege management, which is the second block. And finally, the secure remote access in the third block. We call this platform a universal privilege management approach. You know, we can, from this approach, provide a capability to secure and manage privilege across every session, you know, to reduce the privilege attack surface. If you look also down on this slide, we can see the orange rectangle, which is, you know, our BeyondInsight interface. So this interface can give the customer a single console management, so you can maximize, you know, the visibility, you know, around these privilege accounts. You can simplify the deployment for these three pillars and components, and we can automate many tasks inside these components. Using this interface also, we can discover all the devices in your organization and discover the privilege accounts on these systems. We can manage the policy which are related to privilege accounts and session. And another thing, we can collect and gather reporting information from these devices. And at the end, you know, because we are looking to make the life of the customer or the life of the customer more easy, so we drive a powerful automation workflows. And at the end, we are not working alone. We are integrated with the third-party technology and the, you know, the customer ecosystem. So we can provide more contextual and we can enhance the whole customer environment workflow. Looking to the deployment option, we have really many deployment options. We have on-premise flavor, we have a cloud deployment, and we have a hybrid deployment. In this slide, we are talking about the PAM, or we call it a password management at session management in our platform. So mainly this component can discover and import the privilege accounts automatically. So if you have like a local admin, if you have a domain shared account, if you have a service accounts like, you know, application to database service accounts, some customer, they have application to application service accounts, and we have, you know, SSH keys. So with this component, we can manage all of these, the type of these privilege accounts. We do also vaulting and rotating of the account's password. So we are using internal encrypted vault. And at the end, we are provide a secured gate access to privilege credentials and secrets. To know more about, you know, how the session management how the session management works, let's look together to this diagram. So from left hand side, we have an IT admin who requests an access to the privilege accounts, you know, on specific resources which are sitting on the right hand side in our diagram. So we have some rules inside the PAM component that we are evaluated by the PAM. So we can decide if this user will have access, or this user need any approval, or maybe we can deny the user access. After that, the password will be retrieved from the encrypted vault, and then it will be injected into a session proxy automatically in the real time. And we are not revealing or sharing the credential with these users. So no one will see what is the password or the credential or secret for this privilege accounts. And once the session is established, the entire session will be under PAM recording and auditing. This is another component in our platform. So EPM, or Endpoint Privilege Management, can decrease a surface of attack by many ways. With this component, mainly we can secure endpoints like workstations, servers, and we apply the least privilege model on these systems. We are the only vendor who can really apply a quick start policy, which take a direct effect in the customer environment. So we can call this as plug and play of a predefined policy, which come, you know, from over a years of a company experience in this area. The solution also provide application whitelisting and application blacklisting. For example, we can block all application without know the name of this application, but we can use like, you know, publisher name. So I can block, so we can block or use a rule like blocking all the application which are related to specific vendor name. And the last thing, we can reduce attack surface through trusted application protection. So we can assign just-in-time access privilege for these applications. This is just a high-level design for the PAM and EPM component. So we will not go deeply in this diagram. So mainly we will talk as a high level. So in this design or in this slide, we are talking about active passive architecture, but at the same, we are a vendor who can support the customer who are looking for active architecture. The user in the upper right corner, as we see in this slide, will access to the PAM through a load balancer or through a virtual IP address. So the PAM will proxy the session, and the PAM will evaluate if the user has a privilege or there is any approval for this user to access to the target or not. And once the user access to the target, we have our EPM component there. We will control what the user can do on this target and what the user cannot do on this target. We call this component, you know, as a least privileged component. Secure remote access is the last component in our platform. The solution will manage secure connection to internal resources like workstations and servers without using a VPN. The solution is perfect for allowing vendors, contractors, third party who need privileged access to do their job remotely and securely. And last thing, the solution will create an audit trail to provide a visibility into vendor activity, what they are doing on our network or in the customer network, as well as we meet the compliance mandate by controlling the access to these systems. Here is a high-level design for secure remote access component. So the users or the IT admin or sometimes the vendor or your offshore user, they are sitting at the upper left-hand side and they will send a request over the internet to access to the company infrastructure, which are sitting down in our slide. The connection will be HTTPS connection. It's not a VPN. So we can reduce the number of VPN connection in the customer environment, and we will minimize the attack surface which are coming from the VPN. So the solution will broker the connection. All the connection will be outbound connection to the solution. And once the user access to his interface on the secure remote access, he can see and access to specific systems, and we can control this based on the time, we have a date, and we have approval workflow. The solution will provide a vaulting capability, so we can really inject credentials in real time, and it provides a full audit trail with a video to all the activity that was done on these sessions. So let's now have a demo about this platform and see how these components work together in the real time. Okay, so yeah, this is our BAM interface. So we will start our demo from this interface. Mainly if you are an IT admin and you need to access your target, mainly you need to log into this interface, or we have another option, we will talk about it. We call it a direct connect. So I will accept this message. I have a user called Muhammad. This user will authenticate with his Active Directory account. We can, and we have an option to authenticate locally with the BAM solution as another option. Just log in here. And this is, you know, we call this interface a single sign-on interface. So once you log in as a user, you can access to any of these systems. See, we have some tabs here, the systems, which include Unix, Linux, Windows, HP, Solaris, you know, many, many operating systems here. We have databases. So we support, for example, MongoDB, SQL Server, MySQL, Oracle, you know, main around seven main known databases. We have the domain linked account or the shared account or the domain admin accounts. We have some applications. Some application, they are, you know, they are accessed through a web browser, or some of them, they can be accessed through a console application. And we have another thing, some, you know, a cloud application, we can manage it by the PAM. So if you look here, each record from here represent a one asset. So for me, I can access to any of these assets from using three way. The first way, we I can click on any of these green area, so I can go to the form request and fill that form. Another way, I can click on one click launch, so I can get a mini form, so I can access, you know, quickly to my session instead of going in multiple steps. The last way, we can log into the session using the native tools. I can run the PuTTY, for example, or RDB, and then I can proxy the session from the PAM. We call this way as a direct connect way. No need to log into the PAM interface, but at the end, all activity will be under PAM management. Let me demonstrate the Linux server. So I will click on the green area. For this request, I will use this local account or the root account. I have this asset name or the IP address sometimes. This is, you know, the start date. So for this request, you can define when the request will start it and what the time for accessing this session. So I can define also the start time. Another thing, we have access policy. So in this access policy, I can define if this user or this machine need approval, or I can give the user an auto approve to access to this session. Is there any restriction on the location or in geolocation? I can, for example, restrict, you know, the user from sending the request from a list of IP addresses. So for example, for this user, if he need to log in to Linux 01, he can go to any location, any IP address. So I don't mind what's the requester IP address, but in some cases I can, you know, look to the requester IP address. So if that IP in my blacklisted, I can block, for example, this user from accessing the session. So we can restrict specific IPs, VLANs, subnetworks, or the whole network. It depends on your needs and requirement. Request duration, it defines for how many minutes, hours, or days I need to access to this session. So you can define it before send your request and get, for example, approval, or in our case, it will be auto-approved. Access to the request or access to the session, I can access it immediately using SSH session. So the PAM will invoke the PuTTY as a default tool in my machine, or I can retrieve the password as a clear text. So we have both options. Sharing, you know, the password or retrieving the password as a clear text, sometimes you can disable it. And this is the best practice. No need to show this option for your IT people. But if you need to show it for some use cases, you can enable it and show it for the customer. But before the user requests the password, you need to assign an approval workflow. So no user can show the password unless that user get the IT security or IT manager approval. I can mention the reason for my access. So for example, I want to test something, okay? We can use our, for example, internal ticketing system as a BND trust. We have, you know, internal workflow, or we can use any you know, external ticketing system. We can integrate with some out-of-the-box vendors. For now, I will not integrate with any ticketing system, so I will submit my request. This is my request. Just click on this request again. So this is, we call it the form, step by step, just to access to your session. This is a summary again for my request. The requester is Muhammad. This is the local admin or root account, machine name, request date, time, and the duration, type of access, and the reason for this access. Do you need approval workflow? Approval required mainly zero. I don't need an approval. So this is why the system, you know, make it as auto approve. So I will open the SSH session and then start the SSH session. Now, if you look, I was able to access to my session, okay, automatically. The PAM didn't share any credential with the IT admin, but at the end, the IT admin was able to access to the session using a native tool. So some user, they are using PuTTY, some of them, they are using secure CRT, some of them, they are using, you know, the Windows, you know, default SSH tool. Whatever the tool that you are using, the PAM will check with the registry what is the default tool, then we will invoke and invite that tool to start the session. Okay, so in this session, for example, I can mention who am I. So this is, you know, the logging user, the host name, for example, and we can show it, by the way, you know, from here, but just I need to write some commands here. If this user, for example, try to write some commands, we have a capability to restrict, you know, these commands. So if the user tried to know the IP address of this device, okay, see the title of the session was changed. So we can see session blocked. This is because we have some violation profile inside the PAM solution. And for this user, if he tried to mention these commands, we have some actions like, you know, blocking the screen. We have a block, we have sometimes freeze the screen, sometimes we terminate the session, and we can sometimes allow the user to continue his activity with these violation command, but we can send, for example, automatic email for his manager or IT security to be aware of these activity. Okay. Let's say now, because this user login with, let's say, a standard user or normal user, maybe he don't have a permission to do any activity, we have a capability using our EPM component to elevate this user to run some, for example, root commands, okay? Or run some commands as a root user, okay? So if I mention bb run, for example, to test some commands, who am I? See, and before, you know, I run the who am I, so I get mainly this user. If I run it with bp run, so this bp run command is under EPM management. So I can define for this user if he will be managed by EPM or not. So because this user and this command under EPM management, I show this message. This message mainly come from our privilege management for Unix and Linux. I can customize, by the way, this message is it's not, you know, a static value, so we can change it and modify it. Running the command was run by a root account. With this tool EPM, I can record the session as a video, you know, for the elevation activity, because now I run the command using a root account. Okay, so we have logging for all the activity also, and this is, you know, who run the command. So it was really who am I? I'm the root, but I'm logging, you know, with this user. It's a standard user, let's say. Okay, so this is, you know, the value of EPM technology or privilege management for Unix and Linux. Okay, let's say now I need to add user and enter permission denied. Let's say I need to run this command using bp run. Yeah, this command was executed. So with bp run, and because I'm using the elevation technology, I'm able to allow this user to execute this command with a root account. Okay, so this is, you know, bp run add, and this account was executed by the root. So this is why I can, you know, execute this command. So let me now, we have another capability on the EPM, privilege management for Unix and Linux. I can execute remote commands on another server and no need to log into that server. So for example, if I mention pp run also, minus host, Linux server 02. Yeah, see, now I executed another command. So this command will allow me to jump to another server and access it, you know, with a root account. So yes, I was able to run this command as a root. I'm now accessing, you know, to the second server. I need to verify this information. So who am I, first of all? Yeah, I'm the root account, okay? But I log in, you know, as a standard user. But now I'm jumping to another server. I'm inside that server as a root account. Host name, yeah, I'm inside Linux server 02. So this is another capability we can provide it for the users and for the customer using our privilege management for Unix and Linux. So with this EPM, we can really restrict the activity. We can give the user elevation, mean if you are looking at a standard user, I can give you a root permission to do some activity. So if this user, for example, try to shut down, I'm a root now, so I should do anything on this server, okay? So if I need to shut down this server, see permission deny. This is another thing for the root account. In the normal scenario, the root account should do anything, but with our privilege management for Unix and Linux, we restrict this user from doing anything on the server. I can restrict, you know, at the in the commands. Okay, so let me go just exit from this interface. Host name, I'm back to Linux 01. Who am I? I'm, you know, the standard user. Okay, so all of these activity we did today on this session, it will be recorded. So we record all the activity as a video, and we convert this video into text. Let me now run some command, like, you know, for example, Bing. Oh, not Bing, for example, let me write the kill command. Yeah, see, with kill command, because I mentioned the kill command, okay, and I need to execute this command also, I cannot. It was, the session was blocked again. If I mention, for example, fdisk, to know more information about this session, and I execute the command, see the session was terminated by the PAM solution. Okay, so we have, you know, from as you see, we log in using the PAM. We didn't share any credential with the user, and inside the server, we can restrict what this user can do and what this user cannot do on the machine. Okay, we have, you know, many rule-based access control on these users. Let me just close this session and move back, you know, to request another type of sessions. So with what we did with this Linux server, we can map it to any SSH access request. We are covering switches, routers, HP, Solaris, Ubuntu, Red Hat, you know, any flavor of Unix and Linux. We don't, you know, look to the vendor name. We are looking, you know, to protocol. If you are running this session as SSH, we can manage it by the PAM. Let me move now and test another use case to access to the Windows server. And this Windows server, I need to access it using, you know, an domain admin user. So I have a help desk admin here in my Active Directory. See, the same information, I will get it here. This is the form request. But in this time, I need to launch the one-click launch to get a mini form. So I will click here. So this is a mini form, you know, the same information that we mentioned it. The new thing is the resolution. I can define my resolution with this RDB session, okay? So if I need it to minimize the resolution or maximize it, I can, yeah, select this the option that I want. Now I will open the RDB session. The PAM will communicate with the local tool. So my local tool is the native tool. It's Microsoft RDB. So now I will, you know, log into this session. So look again, the value of the PAM to initiate the request, you know, inject the username and password in the session, and allow you to access you to your target. So now I'm browsing, I'm moving between files, whatever the activity that I'm doing, these activity will be recorded. And as a user, from user experience, nothing will be new because I'm using Microsoft RDB, my you know, everyday tool. Okay. Let me now, during this session, I need to show you something else. For example, if I need to log in with another user, sometimes I have, for example, a user who has a visibility to go and watch all the live sessions. Okay. So I have a user called Zed. This user in Active Directory, so he will authenticate with AD also. With this user mainly, I need to show you that we have a capability to see the active session for this user. It's error, it's fine. So this is the active sessions. If I open the active sessions, I will see really the current running session. So this is, you know, the session. If I minimize here, or the activity, I can watch it in real time. So this is, you know, the IT who opened the RDB, but in the background, we have another user who can watch this session live. From this, as a user who have this capability, I can lock the screen for the user. So this user cannot continue his activity. another activity, we can, you know, cancel and terminate all the session associated with current session. Okay, so I will unlock this user. This means I can give him ability to continue his, you know, duties. If you look to this video, we convert this video into text. So this text will be searchable and we can search for any information inside, you know, this video. We have a local search inside the same, you know, video, or we can, I will show you later on in the demo, how we can search, you know, globally for any command or any information inside, you know, any video already recorded. Now I will terminate and cancel this session. So this session will be closed automatically. Let me go back to that user. Okay, this user. So yeah, I think he has no request. All the requests already closed. So this is my accounts again. One of the capability that we have, we can run application session. So application session mean a console management or web browser. You know, any application you can think about it, we can manage it by our solution. In this scenario, I have SQL Management Studio. Let me go to the form request just to show what we have extra here. So I have here the application name, SQL Server Management Studio. I have, you know, the account that I will use it to log into this application. This application is exists on this on this application server, and I will use the default database to log in, you know, to this application. All other information the same, we talked about them, so I will not repeat the information. I will submit my request, just continue here. This is the summary, and then I get auto approved because no approval for this use case. I will run the application session. If you look with application session, mainly we are running the application itself. So now the PAM, you know, initiate the application, inject the username, the password, the database instance, and as a user, I can now start working on my query. Okay. So this is my query, whatever the activity I want, you know, to do it, I can find it, you know, in the recorded video. These, you know, the commands, it's start to be executed. The point here with application session, if you minimize the application, the session, you will not find anything on this session or in the desktop because we are using, you know, RDS service or RD remote desktop services. So this is usually we, you know, how we manage, you know, the application. So this is a console application. We can manage console application and web browser applications. Okay. Yeah, we'll close this session also. No need to save it. All these things will be also recorded. Same thing with the previous, you know, use cases. Let me now run another type of session, but I will show you how we can control what the user can do and what the user cannot do in the Windows platform using our EPM tool. So let me run these three sessions. I will, you know, simulate some, let's say, use cases here. Yeah, we'll keep this one here. Let me minimize this one. I will use also another session just to, I need to compare mainly two users. They are looking to the same server, but you will see each user will experience different, you know, behavior on the target. Okay. So I have this server, I call it EPM PI Windows 2016. This is, you know, for a Windows server. We can also, you know, restrict the activity on the workstation. So we have the EPM for servers and the, you know, workstations, okay? Let me just, I will close this one, no need to have update. In this use case, I will show you some application. So I have this folder which includes some application, same application for two users. The right hand side session or user will be will have a high flexibility, but in the left hand side this user will have low flexibility or more restrictions. Okay, first of all, I need to run on the high flex, for example, application like PuTTY. If I run the PuTTY, see it was automatically opened for that user. If I move to the low flex user or low flexibility or restriction activity on this user, if the user run the PuTTY, see I get this block message. So mainly this message is a message that come from our EPM solution. We can customize this message and we can really control all the information and manage all the information inside this message. Okay, so sometimes this is, we call it a whitelisting and blacklisting activity. So this is one of our capability in the EPM. Another capability we have, for example, you need to run, some application, they are, run the UAC prompt. So this is, a high flex user. If you run this application, see, I approved his access, but I get notification and audited, and logged his activity on this session. Okay, so this is, the message also coming from our EPM. It's only a notification for this user, and in the background we are logging and recording these activity. Okay, let me go back to the restricted user. If he run the same application, so this is the same application. If he run it, see I get this prompt. Instead of getting the native UAC from Microsoft, we can use our message. We can customize the message. So for this user, if he need to execute and access to this application with a root privilege, because now he is looking as a standard user. So if he need to log into this application, he need a root privilege, or let's say a high privilege account to log into this application or open it. So now if I need to bypass, let's say, this message, I can only get a code from the IT and then click OK to allow me automatically to log in to this application and open it. I will share, some use case how we can use this code. Just I need to show you really how we can control these messages. We have many other use cases. Maybe last use cases on on these server, I will show you how our EPM can communicate with third-party tools. For example, if you have some application and you don't know if this application is trusted or not, so if you need to run this application, I can allow the EPM tool to communicate with VirusTotal to check if this application is safe or this application malicious, so we can take an action. So I have two use cases. I have DLL injector. So this will make some malicious activity on the machine, and if you check it in VirusTotal, it will not be trusted. So let me run it as a user. Now, once you run the application, see the application will contact with a VirusTotal. The result of of VirusTotal evaluation, I get 27 positive results. This means this application is not trusted by VirusTotal. So I can, based on this number, based on this result, I can take an action. So if I click OK, nothing will happen. Why? Because the EPM blocked this application and it prevents this user from executing the application. Another use case on the VirusTotal, if I need to run the Notepad++, we know this is a safe application, but I need to check it with a VirusTotal. So you can check any application without, unknown application with a VirusTotal before open it. So if you look here, I have a zero positive result. This means this application is safe to be run and accessed. So if I click OK, now the EPM will allow me to run that application. So this is some of the use cases we can really execute it with the EPM. We can go more than this if you need, for example, to run any application with admin, run as an admin, I can give you a special message here. If I move back to the high flex user and this user need to run this application with the admin to elevate his activity, see I don't give him the, you know, a one-time code to bypass, but I need from this user to mention the reason why he need to run this application. So he can select it from drop-down menu, or you know, we can customize at the end these information. So just, you know, click anything and okay, then the solution will allow me to execute it. All of these things we can manage it with EPM. So EPM is responsible to control what you can do and what you cannot do on the server. Okay. Let me close this one. I will show the last thing with the EPM. Okay. Maybe in another session or another device. So this user mainly login to this server, and the user need to run the Wireshark tool. So if I run the Wireshark tool, okay. I will get another customized message from EPM. Mainly Wireshark is not acceptable. Before that, I need to get a reason or open an incident automatically with my ticketing system. So we have service now. So for example, I can mention the reason I need to test, then submit the report. Now the incident will be open with the service now. Okay. So this is my incidents number. I can view it as a user. And I can now show you how the admin of the service now or the user can see this incident. So I need to move to the incidents here just to show this request. So yes, this is our request, incident number 3. So this is a privilege management, and the application was a Wireshark. So I will open this incident here. Inside this incident, I will find the challenge code. This challenge code will come automatically by the solution. So as a service now, I will have a tool to generate the response code or the one-time code. So I have this my tool on my machine, for example. Just open it here. I have a security code before generate this code. This is, you know, the code. From this code, I can again share it with the user who submit the incident. I will share this one. You can mention the message that you want. Just I need to simulate it quickly. So post this message, I will go back to the user who are sitting on this machine. Okay, I will log in, you know, as a user to my account. So my account is a high. Now log in here, I can close, by the way, this message, no need to have it. Yeah, this is, you know, all the incident. This is incident number 3 that we get it. And this is, you know, the code that I received from the IT. Okay. So what I can do with this code, I just run, you know, the application again. Just make it big here. Okay, instead of run the incident again, I will enter the response code because I get it from the IT. Okay, I will write the code 89923544, then authorize. Once you get and enter that code, you will be able to access, you know, to your application. So this is another capability. Can we, you know, we can apply it on the machines, workstations or servers. Okay. We can integrate with any third party, VirusTotal, ServiceNow, whatever, because we are really supporting a Power Rules. Power Rules based on a PowerShell, and with PowerShell you can do any automatic activity. I will close this, you know, session. Okay. And now I will simulate another use cases using another account. Okay. I will log out from this user. I will show you how we can build, you know, a multiple layer of security before accessing, you know, to the target. So I have, for example, a DU user. This user will authenticate with 2FA. Okay. So I have, you know, DU security as a two-factor authentication. Once I log in, I need to enter, you know, one-time code from my tool. So just I bring it from here. I will submit the code. So now as a user, I will be able to access and see my assets. I have only one asset here. I will continue my example. So the first security layer, it's AD authentication. Second layer security on our PAM interface is the two-factor authentication integration. And now if I need to access to this machine on this application server using this account, see here, I need approval workflow. So I need one approval and I have a restriction on the IP address. So this machine called WS10, but if you look here, I'm sitting on BI01. So if I get approval, I expect, you know, to be blocked and not and the PAM will not allow me to proceed further because I'm not sitting on this machine on WS10 because I'm sitting on different IP address. Let me simulate this until end. Submit the request. The request was not come as active. It goes as a pending. This red line mean or red color mean I have some restrictions. I will keep, you know, continue. Like I don't know what this restriction. Still, the restrictions are coming here, the red line, so I cannot really access because of this IP, but I need to continue. Approval required, yes, I need one approval. There is no auto approve. Who can approve my request? You know, these people can approve it, okay? So I have this user, Zed, and this user, okay? One of them, if they approve my request, I can access to the server if there is no any restriction. Let me go back to the Zed as a user. I have an approve capability. So you can, you know, based using a rule-based access control, you can define what each user can do in the PAM and what he can see on his interface. So, you know, this is the request. This is the requester, DU user. I need to approve. I can set go ahead, for example, okay? I will approve it here. I will get a notification as a user. So once I get the notification, I can go back to my request. See, instead of continue on the binding, it's go as an active session. I need to access from here. Yes, this is the approval. Zed approved the request and this, you know, the message from Zed. Now I need to open the RDB. If you look here, I get a message, you know, in the tag, location is restricted, which means I cannot open this session because I'm not sitting, you know, as a requester on this machine. I'm sitting on BI01. So this is, you know, a four layer of security, we can build it on our PAM solution before accessing, you know, to the final target. If I get the access, you will get the same session will be recorded and it will be under PAM management. So I will not continue this, you know, more. So just close this session. And now I need to show you, for example, if I'm outside of the PAM interface, I can, you know, allow the users, you know, to access directly without going to the PAM interface. We call this use case as a direct connect. So for example, I have this shortcut. This shortcut mainly you can, you know, download it from the interface, from your interface, okay? Or we can, you know, give you some command, not command syntax, you put it on the RDB and you can access to the session. So these, if you look here, we have this download RDB direct connect. So for RDB, you can find this icon, but for PuTTY or sorry, the SSH or Linux platform, you will not find it, but we can execute it directly from the PuTTY. Let me just, you know, keep it minimized. I will access to the session from here. Just double click. See, now this RDB will communicate with this IP. This IP is our PAM solution, our PAM server. If you look here to the name of the request, I have Muhammad. He is in Active Directory. Plus, I have local admin 1, local admin 1, plus app 01. So this user who called Muhammad, who was, you know, logging here to his interface. This is, you know, Muhammad. Okay. So this is Muhammad logging to his interface. Now he is accessing directly and he need to access to app 01 using local admin 1. So what this password? I should not know the password of the target. So what this password? Mainly you can imagine this password is you know, the web browser password. So now you are authenticating with the PAM, not with the final target. Okay, so now I will mention my password in the PAM web browser. If I click OK, see the session now will be opened automatically. I will verify now that we are really under PAM management. So see, the user or the IT can go directly to the tool and, you know, invoke and initiate the session. Another use case, just minimize this one. Another use case, I can run also the same
session just loaded. This is, you know, the user Muhammad in Active Directory. This is the local admin in the machine, and the machine name is Linux 01. UVM is our appliance name. What is the port here? Is a custom port. So it's not the real port for the Linux environment. It's not a 22. So this port will allow the PuTTY to communicate with the PAM, but from the PAM we will initiate the real communication. So just open it from here. Again, I need the web browser authentication. So this is, you know, my password for the PAM web browser. Now I'm inside, you know, my session. It will be similar to the previous activity. If I mention ifconfig, see the session was blocked, which means it's under PAM management. Okay. If I need to verify it from the, you know, the user who has an active session, if I go to the active session, see I have two sessions. One is app01 and another one is Linux01. And both of them, if you look here for the reason, both of them they are direct connect. This reason will come automatically. And this means I was initiated the session automatically, you know. By the solution. Okay. Now I will show you these. You know, for example, in this session, mainly we see any command you mention it, it will come here automatically, and I can terminate the session. For Windows platform, I can open also the Windows platform, and I see, you know, the recorded session and with the text session. Okay. So just terminate these sessions. I will show you the replay sessions or the previous recorded sessions. So this is the area where we can find all the recorded sessions. See, I have many tabs here, you know, from the beginning of the my PAM solution. Okay. So I can search for any command on these sessions. Okay. And I can use, you know, many filters above. In each column, I have, you know, the column title. We have a filter for specific data. I can search it. I can search for some command. For example, if I search for EMEA underscore all CIF config. Okay. See all the session that I run it inside. If you know all the session that include IF config command, it's come to my interface. So this is, you know, the date of today, or you know the session when we can execute that command. So this session was executed, you know, in this time, another session in this time, you know, it depends, you know, when these commands was executed. We have, you know, many sessions. With these filters, you can define, you know, the date of today. So I can define that, you know, date of today for easy search. But anyway, I will select any you know, session from here. Maybe let me go with this session or yeah, this one. We can, for example, open it from here. If I remove this command, you know, I will get, you know, the all commands executed. I can play this session and I can, you know, click on any of these commands to move the, you know, the cursor forward or backward. If I click on who am I, see the cursor moved back. If I click on exit, you know that the cursor moved to the end of the video. So no need to know where is the command was executed. I can go automatically on the area where that command was executed. Okay. I can write my comment, for example, tested or whatever, mark as review. I can take a snapshot, for example, for this video or whatever. Okay. This is snapshot. It will come as a JPEG. And I can, you know, save and close this session. If you look here, all the activity, it will be recorded. No one can change these information. You know, the PAM will give you also when the frame or the JPEG image was exported or, you know, taken from the video. All of these information, it will be captured. And with these video recording, we are recording based on the activity. We are not recording idle session. So sometimes you will have a long period time. See, this is, for example, 319 seconds, but I get, you know, 26 kilobytes of storage. So because I didn't, you know, do many activity on this session. So we are not consuming the storage of the customer. This is, you know, something important. Okay.
Last thing I can show you before moving to the secure remote access and show one use case, okay? I need to show you the reporting capability. So I will log in, you know, for a user who can run some, you know, reports, okay? So I will log in with the admin of the solution. Okay, this is a local user. So this is, we have, you know, dashboard. Main of all, we have a dashboard for all the solutions. If you look here, we have many dashboards. These dashboards are customizable. You can just go here, add the title, and select, you know, the component that you need to add it to the dashboard. It's a nice dashboard. It will help you as a customer define many information, you know, from a GUI interface. More thing we have also for endpoint privilege management. We have many reports we can generate it. So this EPM can control again what you can do and what you cannot do on the server. So all the events or the activity, we can capture it on this location. It seems it takes some time. Let's see, just moments. See, while reporting is generated, because sometimes it takes time, let me move and show you the last solution, which is a secure remote access. Before it seems it's coming now. So I can see all the events, see all of these events. I can search by platform, by application. If there is, any application path, where is the path of that application in the last, you know, period of time. I can search by the publisher, for example, by the vendor name. Many reports we can generate it. And we can, for example, define, this filter based on the elevation, based on the block activity. If there is any cancel activity happened on during, you know, the elevation, or, you know, during the activity, whitelisting and blacklisting. Okay. Let me just show this one. Yeah, because I have all data, maybe we can just show it again here. Yeah, this is by type, by publisher, all of these information. We can, you know, build a report on that. Action, this is, you know, all the elevated. So this is the application. This is the commit class that are coming from some systems activity. These are the block applications, and you can know more about which application was blocked. It's nice interface. We can really get more information. We have also a Clarity Report. It's, you know, threat analytics tool where we can define if you have any threat, and we can classify the threats from level 0, level 1 to level 10 based on the events that we generated. We have also many built-in reporting. So we have, some reports related to the password safe. So I can, for example, this is, you know, password safe. I can, for example, look for any password and session activity, password release, manage account or manage an account, user entitlement or group entitlement. Many things we can generate. Just click on the report. You have some options. You can define the group here or the target assets you are looking to manage it. You know, the time, the date, many information you can just select it from this drop down menu, and then you can view the report. So this report can mainly download in many formats. So if you need to install download this report, we have Word, Excel, PDF, you know, many formats, and you can make, you know, schedule automatic reporting for specific users. Okay, so many reports, you know, we have a built-in reports, you know, for the PAM and other component. Quickly, I can show you the last component is remote secure remote access. This tool will allow the vendor and external people to access remotely to some systems. I will log in with the admin. So I, for example, I can have access to this external vendor group. I have, for example, this application server. If I need to access it, just double click. I get this notification from the solution. So I'm an external user. Okay. Just click yes here. If this system need a login username and password, the tool will give you the injection capability. So I can, from this orange key, inject the credential. We can get it from our PAM solution, or we can store it locally in the solution. So no need to share the credential with external user. Click OK here.
see the solution, inject the username and password automatically. You can do now your task, whatever you want. More things we can do it here, you know, collaboration tool. In the right hand side, you can do your chatting capability. I can invite other people to join me and access to this session, for example. Okay. Create invitation. You can share this link with any person. Then he can join and access and work with me on the same session. I can send it also automatically by email. We have some collaboration activity here, you know, drawing or whatever. I can run some, task automatically. Like I need to run the task manager. Click on this icon. It will open automatically. So we can control these things. We have also restriction, whitelisting and blacklisting. If you need to run the CMD, for example, and you need to open it, we can, you know, blacklist this application. You cannot open it. If you need also to have a jump or pivoting to another server, remote desktop, we can also control it. Other application, you can, you know, access it easily without any issues. Okay. We have file transfer, easy and excellent user interface, drag and drop, just. We have a command shell where we can write some commands on the background without affecting the user. We can collect, you know, system information, register information, all of these information, we can collect it just in one place for the external user, if that mandatory. I can hide all of these options. So it's a rule-based access. Another thing, I can access Linux command, Linux environment. Same thing, I can inject the credential. No need to share the credential with external user. This is the session. I can run some canned script, predefined script, like, you know, Linux overview. If executed, see many commands in the background was executed. Okay. File transfer will be same GUI interface. It's a nice, you know, drag and drop. Last thing, we can also access application. I have this PRA application. It's our secure remote access application. I inject the username and password. So see, and now the solution will open the PRA, and I will be inside the solution and start working in my application. So now see, I can, you know, do my activity without any issue, and no need to share any credential with external user. And all these sessions will be under the solution management. It will be audited, recorded. You can watch the video and, you know, browsing and do whatever you want. Okay. That's it for today. Thank you for listening. I appreciate your time. If you have, again, any question, you can reach to us during our time in the virtual booth. So I would like to thank you for your time.